Hey boys and girls, it's week 3 and we're doing some new sketches today. I hope you're enjoying the previous sketches that we've done. Today we're going to look at measurement and scale, just going to pop back and look at dimensions, and then we're going to do 3D oblique sketches, which is the new sketches that you haven't done yet. So let's start. Measurement and scale. Let's say we're going to measure this elephant. This elephant is 10 meters long. You can't draw a 10-meter elephant 10 meters onto a page. So we use the thing we call a scale, where we say, okay, if 1 meter is 1 centimeter, then when you draw your elephant will be 10 centimeters. So 10 meters will turn into 10 centimeters. And that is what scale is about. Right. Now, dimensions. We looked at 2D dimensions previously when you did your working sketches. Now we're going to do a 3D drawing. So it's going to be the third picture there at the bottom with a cube. We're going to use those type of drawings which has length, width, and depth. Right, let's start. First thing, a working sketch is a front, side, and a top view, like you see of this boat. A 3D sketch is when you take your working sketch and put them together like that. So you got your front, side, top. And boom, now you have a 3D sketch. This is just an example. Your sketches aren't going to look precisely like this. So let's start with your 3D sketches. Step one, you draw your front view. So you see that at the top there is your working sketch, front side top. This is your front view. Then next step, you draw your sideway lines. They all have to be the same length and they all have to be the same angle. When you take a ruler and you run it across your picture, all the lines have to be in the same direction. Your ruler's direction must not change. Then you know your drawing is correct. Step four, you draw the last bits at the back, and now you have your top view and you have your side view. So you can see in the working sketch in the left corner that you have front, top, side, and at the 3D you have front, top, and side. The last thing that you would do, now this is what it would look like in real life. You've got your drawing, you made the outside lines darker, and then you shade where the shadows and everything will be. And that is your 3D sketches. So in 5 steps, you have a full-on 3D. Right, now we gave you a little bit of work for the week. Please do not continue this video if you haven't done it yet. If you finished it, you can check the memo. So first things first, the stove. So the stove, I'm not going to precisely draw it and show you what you should draw, because I believe that within the 3D sketch, when you add your detail, every child is unique and you have your own imagination and how you would like to draw it. So I'm going to show you the basics. The first step, second step, third step, how to draw the basic outline for the stove. And then what you add, the detail you add and how you add it is up to you. So the stove that you see here is not the one that will look like yours, but the outside lines, the basis has to be the same. So this is what it should look like, more or less. The next one is the house. What you should have noticed is that you've got a triangle shape and a square shape, and they're just, the triangle is put on top of the square, and then you have got a house. So this is what it would look like in your 3D sketch. And then lastly is your ambulance. Now the ambulance is a very difficult drawing. It's one that I put in so to really challenge the children who are really good at these drawings and who really enjoy them. So I'm not going to give you a memo on that. Every one of you is going to try it, see how it works, and use your imagination. I want you to struggle. Just remember, in real life, when people come to you, they're going to tell you, we have an idea about something and we want it to look more or less like this. And then the designer has to use his imagination and draw it. So I want you to use your imagination and trust yourself and draw the ambulance and see how well you can do it. Right, well, that's it. That is it for 3D oblique sketches.